Hey Taurus, it's your girl Dominique with Empathic Guidance, and I'm back with another video for you guys today. These cards been wanting to talk all night. Okay, so this is the Secret Sexual Fantasies. I'm pretty sure y'all done checked out y'all Moon, Rising, Venus, North Node, Cross Watch for your lover, and all of that. So y'all already know what I'm on right now, okay? So a secret sexual fantasy of those that have been out of contact with you for a while, Taurus, okay? All right, so we're going to hop right in. I'm already getting one card. I want to make love with the rain. So this person definitely wants to cleanse the energy between you and them, okay? So, and they also want the romanticism of just being in the rain. Maybe you guys have done that before, and they reminisce about that quite often, okay? That can also be the energy here. All right, so without further ado, let's hop straight in, Taurus. If you guys vibe with me, go ahead and subscribe to the tribe with me, okay? And we're just going to hop right in. I don't need to get a whole spiel. Y'all know what to do. Okay, so. All right, so I'm just giving it a little bit of a shuffle. So I just got done with Aries. And I know sometimes y'all energies can be kind of the same. Just because some of y'all could be cuss babies. But let's just dive right in. Holy divine spirit, angels, ancestors, and spirit guides. Please use me as a vessel of clear, concise, channeled messages for Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, and the North Node for the month of July 2021, Spirit. What is the secret sexual fantasies of the person that Taurus is having no contact with at this time? What is the secret sexual fantasy? Do you miss me? So, okay, oh, I forgot to tell y'all, half of these messages gonna be emotional, and then we gonna dive into two rounds of sex energy, okay? I have too much on my plate right now. Diamond eyes. Okay, so somebody really can't commit their entire, you know, they can't commit their time to you. Whatever they got going on in their life, it's like really time consuming, whether they have a family or they just really career focused right now. We will find out more as we go along what is on this person's plate, you know, but it could be more than relationships and work. You know, sometimes people be having, you know, issues with the law, court dates, and all kind of stuff coming up, you know, self-mastery, just things that they want to work on, you know, and I feel it because sometimes you just don't have that extra time to, you know, dedicate your time to somebody else. But this person does miss you because, you know, a person only asks, do you miss them if they miss you? You are so beautiful inside and out. Your glow up is my karma. Ooh. So maybe this person dissed you. Now they miss you. Ooh-wee. Your glow up is my karma. That's crazy. I have my eye on the prize. And that fell right under diamond eyes. I know who you are to me. So this person may feel like you they twin flame, soulmate, higher level soulmate, past life soulmate. So much about me has changed. I wish you were here to witness. I'm still trying to figure out how to break the ice. So this person want to come back around. And for whatever reason, the fact that it's saying your glow up is this person's karma, they definitely slept on you. They slept on you. They counted you out. They probably chose somebody over you. This person got a lot going on in their life right now. And they saying that they're not ready to settle down yet. And the reason why is because they got a lot going on in their life. But they see you as somebody that's beautiful. And they want to come forth. But the reason why they probably confused on how to start a conversation is because this person's energy is all over the place. They're attracted to you. They miss you. But they can't settle down. They got too much on their plate. All right. I've done some things I can't come back from. I'm sure this person, you know, this love will last a lifetime. My pride ruined this. And I know it. Dang. Whew. All right, so the energy is really heavy here a little. I mean, I don't want to say really. I mean, I guess it's the normal level of heaviness. But yeah, this person, they betrayed you. They definitely did. This person knows by counting you out that they can't come back from it. I don't know what the prize is for them, but this person may be very goal-oriented. And that could have been why they counted you out. I don't know. Like, it's hard to see why this person counted you out. But the thing, one thing is for certain, this person sees you as the one that got away, because with this love will last a lifetime. This person feels like you always gone, like a part of you is always gonna be in this person's energy. This person always gonna hear about you. People in their family and friend group always gonna ask about you. It's like they can't escape your energy, even though you guys may not be together anymore, you know. And this person could be realizing your internal and your external beauty, that you wasn't just a sight for sore eyes, but you was actually a feeling for a sore heart, you know what I'm saying? And this person, they just didn't see that before. And this person know they was prideful. They was prideful, they was egoic. But they made so many changes and they wish that they can express that to you. But again, they don't know how to break the ice. All right, so let's see what else they got, because it's some stuff going on. And I don't know what it is like that could be consuming so much of their life. But let's see though. Okay, Holy Divine Spirit. So when it comes down to Taurus, what is the emotional feelings that this person has towards Taurus? Divine Masculine in reverse. So gate is open. So I don't know if this is a masculine that's actually talking to you, but it's like this person, they took a leap of faith. I feel like an opportunity came for them and they took it, and it could have been a betrayal for you. Like, it could have been an opportunity for them, but a betrayal for you. This person may be your divine masculine, but maybe they opted out of the twin flame journey with you, or this person may feel like they're the divine masculine of somebody else. That could have been their energy, you know, in the past. And with them saying, I know who you are to me, maybe they like, oh shit, I got the wrong one. That, you know, the person I left was actually my twin. I feel like this person definitely was fed some type of fantasy or an illusion that lured them away from the connection here. All right, they took a leap of faith, they walked through, and they realized that something here was an illusion. All right, so they feel a bit duped, and now they feel like the gate is closed. So it's like somebody tricked them. They walked through the gate, and now they're stuck in there. Okay, gate is open, gate is closed. You know, maybe this wasn't really an opportunity. Maybe this person sacrificed you for something that they felt like would be an opportunity, just to find out that it wasn't an opportunity at all. You know, it turned out to be something that they just ended up closing a door, burning bridges with people, and now they can't come back. Or at least that's how they feel. I don't know how you feel, but this is how this person feels. Okay, so what else? Yeah, this person didn't listen to their heart. They didn't follow their heart. Whatever it is that they took a leap towards, like, I'm not sure why they did take a leap, but they didn't stand by you. They didn't treat you like you loved them too. Oh, actually, they went towards something where somebody was pretending to care about them more than what they really did, just to find out it was unrequited love. Now this person is left alone because the person basically shut the gate in their face. Okay, so with the stand by me in reverse here, this person knows that they probably left you at a time that you really needed them. You could have been going through something emotionally. You could have been just not in the best place. But, you know, again, this person was fed some type of fantasy. You know, whoever they went towards or whatever type of situation, it definitely looked better on the outside than it was once they finally got up in the door with it. But, you know, now this person is open for love. They had to release and let something go. But I feel like at the same time, you've done the same thing. When it comes down to them, you have released them and let them go because, ooh, y'all, what did they say? They probably got kids now. So this could be somebody that they left you for, went off, thought that they was going to live their fantasy. And I thought that that something good was a reality, but it was really a fantasy. They might have children out of that. All right, so I'm definitely seeing a karmic release for you. You see this person as a karmic in your life, and maybe they are. If they was supposed to be your divine masculine, they chose the karmic over you, they started a whole life, and they just operated completely out of shadow energy. You know, they switched up the game on you. They wasn't ready to take their divine purpose. New life is in reverse. So here again, children could have been a factor. Maybe they even thought that they got somebody else pregnant. Comes to find out that person was actually pregnant by somebody else, and that could be why the gate is closed. They had an opportunity. They walked through it just to get the door slammed in their face here. But I feel like you've already liberated yourself from this situation, you know. And again, that could have been a karmic that they went towards. And now it's like they coming towards you. And just the same way they releasing somebody else, you've released them. okay, because this person is ready to face some type of reality when it comes down to the connection that y'all had in the past. So this is definitely an ex for you, Taurus. Okay, let's get a sexual round for Taurus. Yeah, this definitely was an illusion. I definitely feel like your person, the person that they went towards, this could have been an energy where they met or under circumstances where people were intoxicated, and every time they met up, they was intoxicated with this person. Okay, and that's the reason why they were so easily fooled, because they really felt like that was a new love opportunity. They was in love with that new person. That person wasn't in love with them, okay? So make no mistake about it. They might be sorry, but they genuinely did fall for somebody else. Yes. And they stopped taking from you. They went into a situation where they basically was kind. They was kind. They invested in this individual. And they went towards them. It was something that this person was doing behind your back. Okay. So they definitely could have left for somebody that they was having an affair with, meeting up with this person. Like I said, spending money on this person. Like I said, it was some. It didn't have to be a narcotic, but it was something that these two was indulging in. Whether it was like, it could have even been as light as wine. But whatever the case is, it was like motivation behind whatever they was doing. And then when the reality finally hit, this person may have found out that whoever they was dealing with, they like things to be more of a thrill than a reality. You know, they like having that illusionary energy. Like, okay, you know, maybe even, I don't know, but I'm getting the energy of this person even asking, like, why did you leave your spouse? You know what I'm saying? Like, this might be the type of person that just like to have affairs or just like to sleep with married people, you know? So, I don't know, but this was definitely a situation where they dealt with somebody that couldn't commit to them also. So, yeah, and it was a burdensome situation. Now they sitting back and they thinking about, you know, how much balance you brought into them, into their life, how patient you were with them. Just they see you transforming your life too. You know, I feel like you might not even have been in temperance energy when you were with this person, but I feel like this person seeing you transform, and this person looking at it like, how did they do that? How did they transform and become so much greater than they was? But it probably was the motivation behind whatever it is that you went through. Like, this person really see that you got your life balanced. Anything that was out of alignment in your life, you gained some sense of like control and moderation over your life. You know, maybe you even learned how to balance your finances more. Like, back in the, you could have been a hot mess when you was dealing with this person. Let's just be honest. But whatever the case is, this person's sick that they slept on you, because with the temperance here, they know that God is looking out for you, and that you being poured into from the universe, you being protected by the universe as well. Okay, so even though something may have really truly hurt you, this person sees you moving on just fine. Now they realizing that they love you, but they also realize that they put, you know, some, you know, the love for something else, whether it was lust or opportunity, and this person was just the opportunist. But I feel like they truly did. They really have feelings for who they went towards. So don't let them tell you it was nothing. It meant nothing, because that's not true. Whoever they went towards, they had emotions for. Now, I feel like no matter how long that's been over, they're realizing like, man, you know, the true love, the true balance, the true moderation, the true energy of two people pouring into each other was with the person that I left behind. Because maybe it was great before this person started showing somebody else attention. You know, I am getting that this person, they felt like they was having a child and they might not be. So this person may want to come in and try to have a child with you. Look at this. I'm telling you. Now they want to marry you. Now they see you as the empress. They see you as abundant. You know, they miss a lot of things about you. They miss your confidence. They miss, you know, how creative you are. For a lot of you, it's like you brought an energy into this person's life like they never felt before, never will feel before. They think you sexy, you beautiful, you know, and now you grounded on top of that too. Because again, I don't know what your personality was like before, but here they saying you grew up. So this person definitely see you evolve into an empress energy. They seen you balance out your life. They see you so much more patient and so much more calm now. Okay. This person is definitely watching you without you knowing. You know, they are remembering the times that they had access to you. Okay, so I'm not even gonna lie. This, you know, they left somebody that they felt just had like a nice ass or something like that. Like this person was just that shallow that they let a big ass lead them out the door, you know? So whoever this person is, they was intrigued because the bottom of the deck is the why for me. You know, and you could have even competed with this person, Taurus. Like maybe you competed with this person to try to get your spouse back. And then you're like, you know what? No, they can have you. Okay. Let's get another round. What is this person wanting to do to Taurus on a sexual level? Because all of this is like talking about the past. Yeah. This person wants to be able to have access to you again. They miss everything. They miss your whole body. You know, if they can't really get with you and just rip your clothes off again one last time. I want to say they like when you leave a little hair down there. But I don't know about y'all. That ain't my thing. But yeah, I definitely do feel like this person, like if y'all actually cohabitated together or y'all was in a situation where you guys spent a significant amount of time at each other's home, this person misses you being comfortable enough to just be naked around them. You know, now they feel like their role in your life is so insignificant that if they was to come, you know, come around you, you wouldn't feel comfortable naked around them. You would feel like you got to cover up yourself. But this person missed being face to face. They miss that missionary. Missionary is a position for love for me, because it's so much where it speaks to intimacy. That's somebody that's wanting to look into your eyes again. They're wanting to feel your heartbeat again. It's like that is a very intimate position, you know. It's like you can feel that connectivity through the heart space, because it's like y'all laying y'all chest to each other. They miss feeling your nails up and down they back. And even like, I mean, I know some men don't like their ass touch, but I don't think they be complaining when they like, when they are, you know, I want to say balls deep, but shit, that might be too much for YouTube, but too late said it. You know what I'm saying? But whoever this is, they miss it all. They miss just being able to call you theirs. And now they just feel like they a part of the crowd. Yeah. They miss living with you. They miss being in the same home with you, just with the comfort. You know, it could even been things that they complained about, like, oh man, her with these incense and things like that. Like, but they miss that ambiance now. They miss you playing your frequencies through the house, or singing through the house, or just being yourself, being who you are. This person misses spoiling you. They definitely miss your breast. Okay, they like your nipples. Some of you guys have like big nipples and areolas. Y'all know who y'all are. But this person is wishing that you would get them another chance, that they can come and live with you, or you can come and move in with them and y'all can really start what y'all had over before again. Maybe you guys used to have car sex back in the day, because this person was saying sex in the rain. But maybe they reminisce into a time where y'all might have tried some spontaneous things, because I'm definitely seeing two depictions of being in a car. Maybe even when you guys first met, you guys really had risky sex where y'all could have been this close to being caught. So maybe you and this person met at work and you guys will sneak off somewhere where nobody could see you and there wasn't any cameras, and y'all would do y'all thing. This person reminisces about all of that. They having all of these memories and flashbacks. If this person was selfish with the sex, like not wanting to go down on you but always want ahead from you, like this person want to show you the truth. So maybe they've gained some type of experience since they've been away from you, if that wasn't something that they would do. Now if this person has been in relationships and stuff like that, I'm telling you, they never stop looking at your news. They always still had your news. They always still looked at them. They always still pleased themselves to it, you know. Because I feel like whoever they dealt with after you was a flop in bed, was boring in bed, was a pillow princess or a pillow prince. you know, or always denying them sex and acting like a nun. This person could have even, I'm not going to say that they liked it, but they could have dabbled with the same sex. I'm definitely seeing the energy of two men here, you know, and it could have just been, you know, some toppy, you know what I'm saying, and not the actual thing, but it could have just been experimental, and it honestly might have not been a masculine man. It could have been a transgender or something to that extent, because I'm getting the energy of the sun in reverse, and it's two men here. I can't show y'all that long. It's two men here, and it's looking like one gave the other one head. You know, this could have definitely been a coworker or somebody that they considered a friend. But I'm getting that whatever that experiment was, this person had returned to it. They didn't like it. Okay. And, you know, that's something that you, I don't know if you, if they are or are not going to tell you. But we are talking about secret sexual fantasy. So maybe this person felt like they just had to try that one time. Okay. But yes, guys, so that's what you're dealing with on a secret sexual fantasy level, Taurus, for the month of July 2021. I really feel like this person just gonna fantasize about you. I don't think that they gonna come towards you, because I feel like it's gonna take bravery, and maybe this person just, they can't dig down deep enough to be able to do that. Okay, guys. All right, guys, so I hope this message helped. Please like, share, comment, and subscribe. Join the Soul Tribe, and I'll check you guys out in the next one.